Hello students, I hope you all are fine and safe at your home. Behalf of JKG International School, I, Kavita Singh, your teacher, is going to start our chapter number 2, that is getting started with CSS. So let's start with the chapter. In this chapter, we're going to learn about what is CSS, why we use it, its syntax and selectors, external style sheets, internal style sheets, ways to insert it, and cascading order. Firstly, I would like to tell you, CSS stands for Cascading Style Sheets. CSS describes how HTML elements are to be displayed on screen, paper, or in other media. It saves a lot of work. It can control the layout of multiple web pages all at once. External style sheets are stored in CSS files only. So this is its syntax. A CSS rule set consists of a selector and a declaration block. We are having selector block and a declaration block where we get the property, value, property again, the value again. Fine. What it is used for? CSS is used to define styles for your web pages, including the design, layout, and variations in display for different devices and screen sizes. Your audience will listen to you or read the content but won't do both. Fine. The selector points to the HTML element you want to style. The declaration block contains one or the more declarations separated by a semicolon. Each declaration includes a CSS property name and a value separated by a colon. A CSS declaration always ends with a semicolon, and declaration blocks are surrounded by curly braces. We have three versions of CSS. First was released 1996-12-17, 1992-5-12, and 2015-10-13. Fine. So this is a basic example I'm showing you. In this, the programmer has mentioned HTML head style, color is red, text alignment is center. Fine. Then style is closed here, which was started over here. Head is closed, which was started over here. Then body is started. P specifies the paragraph hello world, and P closes. P started again. These paragraphs are styled with CSS. Paragraph close. Body close, which was started over here only. And HTML, which was started earlier at the start of the program, is closed here in the end. With these, we can find out this output, hello world, which is in red color and center aligned. And another paragraph was started here with the lines, these paragraphs are styled with CSS. This is also red in color and it is also center aligned. So this is the basic example. Now we have three ways to insert CSS. Fine. External style sheets, internal style sheets, inline style sheets. Firstly, we are going to discuss about external style sheets. With an external style sheet, you can change the look of an entire website by changing just one file. Each page must include a reference to the external style sheet file inside the link. The link element goes inside the head section. We'll just provide a link section here, a link tag over here inside the head section only. Okay. Then it is internal style sheet. An internal style sheet may be used if one single page has a unique style. Internal styles are defined within the style element, which we used earlier, inside the head section only. Fine. It is also used in the head section. Next we have inline styles. An inline style may be used to apply a unique style for a single element only. To use inline styles, add the style attribute to the relevant element. The style attribute can contain any CSS property. It can use any property entire the program. Lastly, we are having multiple style sheets. If some properties have been defined for the same selector in different style sheets, the value from the last red style sheet will be used. That is the basic funda of multiple style sheets. Okay. that would be the end of our video. I will, if you are having any query, we'll be solving that in our Zoom, in our Microsoft session. I'll be waiting for you guys. Thank you and have a nice day.